What's up, guys? Happy New Year. It's 2016. This is officially season 9 of the Pete's Basement Show. Thank you so much for tuning in. Here's to you. Salud. I hope 2016 brings you much happiness and everything that you could possibly ask for. We got a great show for you tonight. We're going to catch up on some highlights of the last couple of weeks that we've been on vacation. We got the last contract from Boom Studios. We got DC's Swamp Thing, number one. We got Image's Four Eyes, Hearts of Fire. We got Marvel's A-Force, number one. Spider-Man and Deadpool. And Obi-Wan and Anakin. Now, I know we have a lot more books than that, but you'll just have to tune into the Extras channel once me and Ramon take care of the rest of those. For now, it's all about moving forward. It's season 9. Watch the intro, and we'll be right back. So, anybody got any good New Year's resolutions over the course of the year? Let me steal a little bit of that water, please, sir.
I got these Funkos at NYCC. Are they officially out now? I got those
yes.
Funkos at NYCC. Oh, yeah.
Yes, actually, these just came out. Ramon was kind enough to pick these up for me at a comic book shop in Philly.
Yeah.
Called Brave New Worlds Comics and Toys. Which I didn't even know that was the name of it until you showed me the card.
Yeah.
I love Brave New World. It's one of my favorite non-comic books. Written by Aldous Huxley back in like the 30s or so. And amusingly enough, it's all about people taking drugs to kind of, you know, get by in their lives. And it's they're like taking anxiety pills and all kinds of things, and it keeps them happy. It's called Soma. If Aldous Huxley knew then what the world would be like fucking now, people would have thought he was clairvoyant, I swear. It's a really phenomenal book. I highly recommend it.
I think it's a reach.
I know. I understand. All right. So, we'll clap this in, and we'll get started officially. Here we go. Dude, that was a sucky clap for the new year.
Yeah.
That was better. That was way better. Welcome back, guys. It is Season 9, this is me and Ramon. Roger's not here, but we wish him all the best. Roger is currently on a road trip with his wife and son, and they are headed down to Cape Canaveral, Florida, because that's where I am going to be tomorrow. I am flying down there Friday afternoon, because on Saturday, Pete's Basement goes to space.
Which is dangerous.
Damn right.
Letting you next to rockets is crazy.
You remember our boy Chris Craddock, who's come on the show? He is still, to this day, holds the record for the only guy to ever wear a suit on the Pete's Basement show.
Yes.
Absolutely. Because even when I was in a suit for Comic-Con, that doesn't count. On the show, in the basement, he was in a suit.
Yes, Twiggy, I still don't drink.
No, Moan don't drink. And I haven't driven him to it yet.
But 9th year might be it.
So, headed down to Cape Canaveral, Florida, where our boy Chris Craddock is going to be testing a new type of, like, engine for NASA. The homeboy's a straight-up rocket scientist, if you guys are just tuning in. He literally works for NASA. He builds rockets. So he's a rocket scientist. Like, that actually, like, that happens.
What we're doing is we're testing a new type of aerospike nozzle that hopefully is going to be able to change the rocket industry to the point where we can do single-stage to orbit, meaning turning rockets into airlines, so you don't have to throw away things as you go up. We have to actually do science here. We can't just guesstimate, so we're burning three different engines to see which works the best. We kind of already know which works the best, but you know, we actually have to show the math and show that, oh yeah, we actually did the real test in real world to show that it did do that. After we get that done, we're going to plug one into a rocket and send it up about 1,000 feet or so, just to make sure that rocket works before we do a high power launch in about another month.
Now, this is a 3D printed engine. Like, yeah. You guys made this on a printer, on a computer. It wasn't, you know, manufactured in a factory, on machines or anything like that. Tell us about that.
This is very much a people's rocket. It's so accessible because it costs us about $300 or $500 per print. And we actually printed the damn thing out of titanium, which is phenomenal.
And he has kung fu.
And he knows kung fu. And his kung fu is strong. Very, very good. So Chris called me up several weeks ago, and he was like, "So you guys want to put your logo on the rocket?" And I'm like, "Well, let me think about this. I mean, it's a lot to, you know, it's a lot of responsibility, and I have to make the vector arm, I have to size it." Yes! Yes, I want my name on a rocket! It's a fucking rocket! It's a rocket, and it's going to space! I want the logo on a rocket because it's a rocket! Did I mention it's a rocket?
Ninjutsu. Yes, Craddock is a ninjutsu guy.
Oh, to quote Master Ken, ninjutsu is bullshit.
Yeah, uh-huh. Don't start now.
I know he's laughing. So, headed down to Cape Canaveral. Make sure you guys tune in. There will be a special Periscope episode of Pete's Basement. 10 a.m. sharp Eastern Standard Time, Saturday morning. We're going to launch the rocket, and we're going to hope for the best. Sunny Florida, baby. Here I come. Oh, yeah.
Be afraid.
Congratulations, by the way, Chris. All the best. It's pretty fantastic that you're doing that, and it's an even bigger honor that you allowed the Basement Show to
Relic
be part
Lord
of it.
Wants to know, have you figured out a new pay service for us yet? It's forthcoming.
And the beauty of it is there won't be any mandatory payment at all. All the shows are going to be free of charge. I will let you guys in on the double secret fucking probation
Major
idea.
Reaction, no Patreon?
Patreon.
Exactly.
That's where we're going.
Yeah.
So, really, the only thing that's holding us back now is we're just kind of figuring out the rewards of it all. But it will involve, you know, different extras and maybe even, you know, video chats. And maybe we can get you guys on the show, shit like that. It's going to be a lot of fun. Roger and I are just kind of working out the kinks.
Yeah, and also there's been the holidays. Roger's mom's and wife's birthday are on the same week.
I've been really, really
Valentine's
drunk.
Day.
Really drunk.
He's drunk.
Honestly, guys, New Year's resolution, I'm going to try and stave off some of the drinking.
Pete.
What?
Lunch with Pete.
Lunch with, hey, if you're in the tri-state
Chris
area.
My life away.
Who?
Chris my life away.
Chris my life away. I just said Chris from Rockaway.
No,
I'm like,
Chris
I'll come to you, bro. Fucking lunch at the beach? Hell yeah. But either way.
Piggyback rides. If you're a chick and a skinny
one. Wait, who's getting the piggyback rides? Do I got to give them or am I getting one? I'll take a piggyback ride from a dude. I don't give a fuck. Clothed, of course.
Hey, Monk is on. Hey, Amy.
Oh, I thought you meant Monk was on. I was like, I love that show.
Yeah, Monk.
Hey. How are you, Amy? Happy New Year,
dude. Happy New Year.
Oh, man. So, like, right off the bat, who has seen Star Wars? I hope everyone has. I saw it opening day. It's one of the only times I managed to see a movie before this guy.
I saw Star Wars the last day of the year.
Mm-hmm.
I avoided the whole spoiler thing you did.
I am very proud of you for managing to do that. And honestly, before you continue, I want to say how proud I am of the entire internet.
No, I got a spoiler off the internet.
Okay, there were a couple of dickheads.
Yeah, there were.
But the vast majority, like 99.99% of people.
Amy, you're going to get spoiled, man. She's telling a shh, but.
No, we're not going to talk about nothing.
Okay, we're not. But there was a spoiler.
There were a couple of assholes. And unfortunately, there were a couple of comments in some of the pictures we posted. And I'm like, motherfucker. And I deleted them, but. You know, unfortunately, I didn't get to them fast enough. It did wind up ruining it for some people. I hope it hasn't been ruined for a few of you guys out there. We do have a completely spoiler-ridden review up on our extras channel right now. It's me and Cheeseburger Pete versus Rich and Trish. Me and Pete loved the movie. Trish and Rich did not, but they don't like anything.
Stonefish says, I can't believe that Jar Jar Binks is Supreme Leader Snoke.
Absolutely. They should really put Jar Jar in it somewhere just to be killed.
Yeah, like a corpse.
Something. I want to know what happened to him. I really do. The sadist in me wants to know.
I didn't hate it. I liked it. I enjoyed it.
It was by no stretch a perfect movie. But then again, neither were the originals.
No.
They're wonderful. They're original, classic films, but they're fucking hokey.
They're original because of their legacy and their history.
Absolutely.
Not because they're fucking good movies. there was just a lot of parallels between the first trilogy and...
Amy, I don't find that to be a spoiler. The biggest complaint that people are making is that it's exactly like A New Hope all over again. And to those people, I say, shut up. Shut up, because A New Hope was great, and that's why this is good. The last time we wanted something new, we got the prequels. Shut up. Shut up. Thank you. A New Hope worked. Don't fuck with what works. We got Episode 7. Done. And Rey is so beautiful.
Whoa.
She has such a great smile. I melt every damn time.
Yeah, you kind of want her and Melissa Benoist
to have a smile off?
No, in a room with you. They're both fucking adorable. You want to do horrible things to them.
I just kind of want to poke them for a second. Like, just, it's like you're real.
Rey is stunning, according to Darth Mayers. And Amy Monk is going to meet Chris Evans.
That's awesome.
Padme is better?
Nah, dude.
I mean...
I respect your opinion,
Natalie
but...
Natalie Portman is an attractive woman. She is. Hands down. Especially after seeing her in The Swan.
She's cute. Black Swan, but... is she hotter than... Nah, I don't think so. I'm sorry.
She doesn't have that cuteness. Well, Natalie Portman's just... I don't know.
I seen her bald in that Jewish movie, and she really shaved her head for that.
Was it Free V for Vendetta she shaved her head?
No. Well, that's right. She was bald in that. I forgot that. So... How did everybody's nerd Christmas go? I hope everybody got what they wanted. I got fucking plenty. The best part about this, is this is why I'm showing it off, is it's perfect for the winter because it's got its own built-in face mask and hoodie. It just dropped that shit down. Yeah, I got so many looks in the subway like this. I went to work like this. Everybody at my office loved it.
I'm sure they did.
Absolutely. I was like, I am Optimus Prime. But honestly, guys, I just wanted to show it off real quick in the beginning of the show. I got that for Christmas, but it is way too hot in the basement to be wearing that, so...
Yeah, you're sweating, and that's my job.
My Galvatron shirt.
Galvatron was one of the few times that redesign worked.
Yes, it was.
Ever.
Still to this day, one of the best lines in any cartoon, when he's like, Megatron, is that you? Here's a hint. And he transforms into the cannon and kills his ass up. Oh, that was great. My cousin got me this really awesome Marvel encyclopedia. It's heavy as fuck. You could just beat somebody with this.
It's on Instagram, hey.
Ramon cracked it. And he was... Not cracked it. I mean, he cracked it open. Was reading through it before. My boy Tommy Two-Step. Y'all know him. He's the big ball buster on Instagram. His parents... For my birthday, which was January 2nd, by the way, got me this little gumball machine. Does not have gumballs, but... That's pretty badass.
That is awesome.
So, a big thanks to Helen and Tom for that one. I love it, and I gotta go over to Dylan's Candy Bar and get myself some gumballs. For those of you not familiar, Dylan's Candy Bar is a big-ass candy store in the city.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
It's just cavities waiting to happen. I think it's run by dentists.
Nibrock Moore says that he hasn't won.
The gumball machine?
Yeah.
Nice, dude. Nice. I also Grouponed myself a lightsaber, which I'm really hoping is good quality.
It should be.
I hope so. I mean, I've Grouponed plenty of shit before and they've come back really good. What else do we have to talk about? Daredevil's cut. We got the date for Daredevil.
Teaser trailer?
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck you call that. That bored me.
Yeah.
Like, I was really expecting at least something. All it is rehashed dialogue from season one. The only thing it gave us was the date officially, which is March 18th.
Yeah.
It was going to be March 25th, which would have been a really dickhead move by Marvel.
Yeah, it would have.
I mean, not for nothing. Let's look at the facts here. Batman and Superman was scheduled for May 6th. Marvel turns around and says, all right, we're going to give you Captain America Civil War the same day. So DC, under pressure from Marvel and not wanting to have a head-to-head battle, moved it up to March 25th. And now recently there was a huge rumor going around the net that said Daredevil was going to drop March 25th, same fucking night as Batman Superman gets released. Mm-hmm. And according to what we've read, according to rumors... under pressure from DC, threatening to pull some of their programming and to be delayed with other programming, Netflix was the one who turned around to Marvel and said, y'all can't do this.
I mean, It's better for the industry.
Listen, a lot of it seemed like Marvel was really after a head-to-head battle, like of which one's more popular.
Luke is coming out this year too, right? Question mark.
Luke who?
Stoneface is asking about Luke. What do you mean coming out this year?
Skywalker? Oh, Luke Cage. Yes. Oh,
yeah.
November-ish, give or take, right around the same time Jessica Jones did this past year.
Wasn't it announced that the actual Suicide trailer is coming out?
We actually had one of those questions from Instagram, and I'm not sure when we could... I'm sure we'll get some sort of teaser during the Super Bowl. There's got to be something. I don't know if it's going to be anything major like for Rogue One or for Doctor Strange, but we might get a teaser for Suicide Squad come Super Bowl.
Yeah. God knows we've seen plenty of Deadpool.
Yeah, really. And I cannot wait for Deadpool.
I can't wait for Deadpool. Oh, my God.
I have never been this excited about a Fox movie, I think, since the very first X-Men movie came out back in 2000. And we didn't know any better back then.
Yeah. Uh-huh. That's pretty much it. It's just... Yeah.
Deadpool looks so on point.
And I don't bother with his book.
You
want to
see the Supergirl show? Any good?
Oh, my God.
Supergirl's great. Supergirl is... Today? Yes.
You sure?
Yes.
So this week?
Yes.
How fucking awesome is it?
So good.
Oh, my God. Who wrote Matt? Super Craddock wrote Matt.
Why Dude, come Matt? On, man. It's as lighthearted and fun as The Flash. But she's prettier than Grant Gustin.
Way prettier.
And I mean, Grant Gustin's a cute girl, too, but still. I'm just kidding, Grant. I really am. However, Candace Van Patten, if you're watching, you're gorgeous. Who, what?
So are my balls.
Well, I mean, I'm sure they are. I don't want me to tell you.
I don't know what to say to that.
Listen, we're not getting that drunk tomorrow night. I'm telling you right now. It's not going to happen. Oh, man.
That took a turn. Yes, Monk, it did.
I mean, I'm sure you guys know by now, because it was spoiled for me within like 5 minutes of missing the fucking episode, Martian Manhunter is running around on Supergirl, and he looks phenomenal.
He does.
He look like I think all the budget went into him.
Yeah. When he, in the end of this week's episode.
Sure.
Spoiler alert, in case you haven't seen it, but it's been a few days.
Weren't you wondering which one he was?
I was.
Uh-huh.
And it was done really freaking well.
Yep.
When he changed on the roof, though, there was like a slight little glitch, but that's TV graphics for you. It's not going to be... I'm like, okay, Roger could have done that better.
Supergirl is running on a limited budget right now. It doesn't have Flash money.
Especially with those Kryptonians they pulled out.
Give the popularity a chance to catch up, and the budget will increase.
How many episodes in it is it in so
20.
Far?
No, so far? I'm sorry, I don't know.
Is it 10? No.
I want to say it's about 10.
Well, 10.
10, yeah.
Yeah, you could, like, you know, find it somewhere and binge on it. You should. You really should.
You could definitely find it through unscrupulous means. Actually, it's CBS, so it should be on demand. Hey. The only one that's a dick and doesn't put shit on demand is CW11. I'm talking to you, motherfuckers.
Yeah, the budget for Red Tornado looked kind of funky. Yeah. But I think that's just going to come later on.
But I liked his superpowers and everything. I liked the way he handled himself.
I think he's going to come
back. It's just
back
the look, different. Like how he looked when he wasn't being super powerful.
Yeah.
Like the whole glitter thing.
That weird armor.
Yeah,
He's going to come back better. We're still not done with Hank Henshaw. The name and Cyborg Superman.
Right.
He's just...
Give it time. That it's a dangling... It's an open thing.
So I'm looking forward to... Yeah. A newer Red Tornado.
Mm-hmm.
I'm looking forward to Cyborg Superman once they figure out which face to use for the Superman part.
Looking forward to the White Martians are coming.
Yes, that's so fucking awesome.
Ms. Martian is coming.
That'd be nice to see another like, alien like her age.
Bizarro is coming.
Actually, they should have kind of sort of mentioned the last episode in the end.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. The Flash is still the best of the shows.
Mm-hmm.
Stoneface says. Yeah.
Without question, Flash is still my favorite show on the air.
But if it was season one of The Flash compared to season one of Supergirl.
Still better.
You think so?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. Yes. Because even though they put out a lot of villains out right away.
There was a major villain in Flash that you immediately latched onto.
What if we got a Young Justice out of Supergirl? What if? I don't know. What if? Maybe.
What if indeed? Do we know something?
Amy, you haven't seen Flash?
You haven't seen Flash, Amy? What are you doing?
Amy!
Ugh, it's so good. Watch it. Forget Arrow. Watch Flash. The season one is on Netflix.
You can't forget Arrow because there's some crossovers.
Yeah, I know. But for the most part.
Young Justice cartoon was amazing. Yes, it freaking was.
Yes, it was.
That's Chris My Life Away. You can't. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. She's a busy person.
Hey, preaching to the choir, girl. It happens.
Why did they cancel Young Justice anyway?
I don't know why they canceled it. It makes no sense to me.
The question was for Periscope can hear, but it's being recorded over here. Why did they cancel Young Justice? God only knows. They get bored sometimes.
Yeah.
So guys, we realize that there are a lot of books that have come out over the course of the last 3 weeks. Yeah. Especially like the Christmas and New Year's weeks. Like, yo.
It kind of pissed me the fuck off.
Yeah, like they know better.
You can't take a break?
They always took breaks. There was like 3 or 4 books coming out that you did not need to worry about.
And
now they're dropping shit like it's a regular week.
Oh, no.
Like anybody wanted to go to Midtown Comics and be anywhere near Times Square on the Wednesday before New Year's Eve. When there's already crazy bastards outside camping.
Yep. Yep.
Guys, if you come to the city, and by the city I mean my city, New York.
It's your city?
Yeah. Like Batman says, it's my city. There are a couple of things you have to realize that we have never done. What's that? How dare you spend time with your family? You can't. That place was a war zone. Were you there? Were you actually there? Who was that?
I don't know. Midtown got mentioned in Paper Girls 4.
Nice. I didn't read 4. I read 3.
Wow, there's more than I have.
You're not up on Paper Girls? You're the one who got me into that shit.
I'm behind on everything.
All right, fair enough. We had a question about Paper Girls on the Instagrizzy. Hold on. Let me look. Ah, Darth Myers wanted to know, when do you think the teaser trailers will drop for Doctor Strange, Rogue One, and Episode 8? Don't hold your breath on Episode 8. It's probably not going to be until next Christmas.
Yeah, maybe you get a teaser or something, like a poster.
Yeah.
Poster, that'd be...
You might get a teaser for Episode 8 during Civil War, and it'll be like one of those really, like, minuscule teasers.
Yeah.
But while the... I almost said the Phantom Menace. Good Christ, punch me in the face. While Episode 7... is in theaters, I don't think you're going to see a teaser for Episode 8. Paper Girls has been great. Are you all reading it?
Yes, we are.
Yes. I love Paper Girls. It did not take the turn I was expecting, I will tell you that much. I was expecting like a crazy kind of suburban horror murder story, and then all of a sudden aliens and other dimensions. Okay, I'll bite, but definitely went, like, we're going this way, and left turn at Albuquerque.
Oh, kind of like The Woods from Boom?
Yes, kind of like The Woods from Boom, which is still going.
Yeah.
And shows no signs of stopping.
Yeah, I'm surprised about that.
I'm a little tired of it, but I've invested this much time that I have to keep going.
How awesome is Cumberpatch looking? How awesome is Deadpool's marketing campaign? Deadpool's everywhere, and it's hilarious.
The marketing for Deadpool is spot on. Whoever thought all of this up, from the 12 days of Deadpool before Christmas to... all of the shit.
It's like Deadpool's doing his own marketing. It's perfect.
The thing in the movie theaters where you can sit on his lap. I did. I actually have to post that still as like a later gram kind of thing. I forgot to put that up when Pete and I went to see Star Wars in the theater. I sat on Deadpool's lap.
Two Pete's and Deadpool.
Oh man, it was so funny.
Negasonic Teenage Warhead is amazing. She is cute.
Yo, who is this bro?
I don't know.
Alright.
I don't know. And Cumberpatch
looks amazing. Awesome.
He's like fucking Doom.
This is going to be one of those movies Strange. Where, like, I mean, Doctor Strange, let's face it, is not one of the most popular characters in the Marvel Universe. And by popular, I mean he doesn't really carry his own book well. He's better off as a guest star or a team member or something like that. The fact that they're going to produce a movie that, and I said the same shit about Thor. I'll come right out and say it. When the first Thor movie was coming out, I'm like, I mean, for people like you and me and all you guys out there, we all knew that we were going to be excited about Thor.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't think the general public would take to it.
I didn't think so either. Mm-mm. Same thing with Guardian, same thing with Ant-Man. I'm like,
yeah,
fucking Ant-Man.
At this point, it's like Marvel could just feed you anything and we'll eat it up.
Yeah.
Because it's really good. And I'm not trying to sound like one of them fanboys out there because, I mean, I love DC shit too. And I try to give DC movies the benefit of the doubt. I have my problems with them. But nevertheless,
Doctor Strange is going to be one of the most visually stunning movies you're ever going to see. I promise you.
Craddock doesn't like Ant-Man either. They never know what to do with characters with magic-based characters in comics. Yes! Oh my God, Stoneface. I'm so hoping they put together Scarlet Witch, Hercules, Weird World, Black Knight, and Doctor Strange. They're really putting out a bunch of like magic books or magic-based books. Even though Scarlet Witch isn't fucking magical, she's a fucking mutant. Stick to what she is. But anyways, I digress. I'm really hoping they do something right with that. Yeah. My wife doesn't bother with the comic books, but she loves the movies.
Oh, one final touch on Paper Girls. Darth Myers said, the 80s references are top-notch, and the self-addressed stamped envelopes and surveys at the end are a blast from the past. I was ready to complete one of them surveys. I wasn't even sure if they were real or not.
What?
At the end of Paper Girls, there's, like, the questionnaires. Oh. I'm like, if I send this shit in, where's this going anywhere? I can't read, so the movies help. Way to go, two steps.
We love you, Tommy.
Yep.
Happy New Year.
Well, Tommy is a product of St. Cecilia's Catholic School, so that is probably why he can't read. Brooklyn can only do so much. We got a good one here from Call of the Wild. Said, if you could get one toy back, what would it be? I was always jealous that I never actually had this as a kid. It was the Legend of Zelda board game. Some punk in first grade would never let me play with him. First of all, sir.
Wait, get something back or get something you never had?
Either one.
If I could get something back that I had, it would be He-Man and Battle Cat.
Okay.
I used to have... come on. Oh my God, Silverhawks. Yes. That needs to be a movie made, but anyways, that's a conversation for another day. If I could have something that I never had before, I went to a friend's house once. And he had this one of those China sets, you know, where you put your dishes and shit in. And for some reason, on top of it, he had two things. The G.I. Joe helicopter, that big old...
The Tomahawk, yeah.
No, the one for the doctor.
The Tomahawk.
Yeah, that.
Yeah.
It was fucking massive. Yes, that it wasn't is. It, though. To the right of it was Ultra Magnus.
No, Fortress Maximus.
The full Ultra Magnus.
Ultra Magnus was the blue trailer.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, the truck.
It was massive. It was like this long. I was like...
No, Ultra Magnus was like this big. It was like the same size as Optimus Prime. Yeah.
No.
Which one are you thinking of? Are you thinking of Fortress Maximus?
No, it was a vehicle.
I got to go to bed. You guys are awesome. I'll see you guys next week.
See ya.
Who dat?
Amy.
So long, Amy. Best of luck at the convention.
Oh, am I missing something?
Ultra Magnus was no bigger than Optimus Prime.
Really?
Yeah.
No.
It was blue with a white truck.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Perhaps you were little and that's how you're remembering it larger than life.
That could be it. And it was also
that shit happens, yeah.
Yeah.
Honestly, first of all, Call of the Wild, I never knew there was a Legend of Zelda board game. I had to eBay that shit immediately.
How much?
$80. It's not terrible.
So you're getting it?
Maybe.
It's on the way already, isn't it?
Nah, it's not the way. It's okay. Not on the way yet. If I could get one, I mean, we're talking about board games for a second, so if I can get a toy back, y'all remember Fireball Island? Remember playing that game? Yo, that shit is pricey. That's like a $200 board game. Ridiculous.
The Kraken from the 1981 Clash of the Titans.
There was a toy of that?
That's what Craddock says.
Never knew that. Love that movie. Love it. If I could have one toy, obviously it's the aircraft carrier. I really want the flag.
Majority.
Well, I guess we should talk about a comic book. I mean, that's what we're here for. Hey. Now, guys, like we said, there have been a lot of books out over the course of the past several weeks. So we're only going to talk about a couple of minor highlights. For all the rest of the stuff, be sure and tune in. Ramon and I are going to make some extras channel stuff.
Yeah,
and that's where we'll talk about all the rest of the nonsense, all of the number ones, and we'll try to get to the 9 zillion books that have ended.
Oh my God. Not to mention next week is Secret Wars finally ending.
Secret Wars finally ending. Book of the week, according to the big guy, is Image's Four Eyes, Hearts of Fire.
Yes.
Batman. Why?
Does Batman get seduced to Darkseid with Kylo's shuttle?
Batman can't get seduced by the Darkseid. They already tried that shit. They tried to give him a Sinestro ring, and he powered through it.
He should have taken it.
He should have taken it.
Yeah. All right. When I first saw this, and I saw the solicitation for it, I was like, it's from a previous shit. All right, fuck, I'm going to get lost.
Right.
And then I looked up the solicitation for that shit, and it was like, it was prime image. One book came out 1 year, the second book came out the following year. It was just that bad. It was only 4 books. So I'm like, okay, I didn't miss shit. This is like the Depression era.
Mm-hmm.
And this kid who's trying his best to earn a living to help out his mom.
Okay.
So he's working on a farm, and on his farm happens to be a pet dragon.
All right.
It has four eyes, and that's why they call it Four Eyes.
The dragon has four eyes?
Yes.
Okay.
And the thing is to train your dragon so you can do, like, dragon pit fighting. So it's the Depression era, exactly the way we remember it in history books.
Does it come with an instruction booklet for how to train your dragon?
No.
Huh.
Oh, my God, if you ever had a dragon, I'd be afraid. His dragon happens to be blind. But that's going to build up along eventually. So the owner of the farm takes him to where the other dragons are trained. Right. And he's freaking out because it sounds so different. He can't figure it out. It turns out their dragons are trained in a very rough way that they're always
screaming. And he teaches him how to train your dragon too?
He's going to eventually teach him how to train his dragon. Smart ass. I know what you're fucking doing. So that's where the book comes. Now, the book is, I liked it. I was not expecting to like it. But it's drawn really nicely.
Okay.
Like, uniquely nicely. Not like, oh wow, it's like drawn like Jim Lee nicely. Jim Lee fucking draw my books, bitch. 2016, knock the shit off.
I feel anyways. The same way about J. Scott Campbell.
Oh my God, J. Scott Campbell, draw a book, please.
Did you see, though, not for nothing, A-Force came out with the...
oh my God, yes!
The 90s variant with Danger Girl, the Danger Girl variant?
Yeah.
So... Ramon and I were very excited to see Swamp Thing making its way back to the MCU.
Yes, because why did they cancel it? And when they canceled it, they rushed it, right?
Yes.
Oh, my God. And this bastard got me hooked on that shit.
Uh-huh.
And lo and behold, a couple of months later, they canceled the shit.
This one picks up. It's good. It's Swamp Thing. It bears no resemblance that I can see to the previous storyline. Thus, kind of taking on DC's whole... Fuck continuity.
Listen, as long as he's not on Instagram or tweeting when he's in the comic book, I'm all right with that.
Yeah, I agree.
Because that's like what all comic books
are. And he's not fighting Arcane. He's fighting some crazy zombie thing, which I've never seen before. I am new to just about all of the Swamp Thing universe. So, this is kind of like my virgin go. The New 52... was the first time I'd ever read Swamp Thing and really become interested in the character, with the exception of, like, the 80s movie.
Yeah.
With Adrian Barbeau, and holy shit.
Yeah, forget about it.
So, yeah.
I haven't seen that
one. I'm very happy to see Swamp Thing back. I enjoyed the book. If there was something in there that I missed that makes reference to the past title, please somebody fill me in. You guys know the drill by now. Questions at petesbasement.com. Facebook.com/Pete's Basement, and follow us on Instagram and Twitter for up-to-the-minute reviews and rumors and things that are not rumors, but we have to call them rumors and all sorts of stuff.
Yeah.
We're good for that kind of shit.
We are.
But nobody knows it. We have to keep quiet about it.
Why is a dirty sewer swamp cool?
What?
Why is a dirty sewer swamp cool?
Craddock.
It's a joke or something.
Why is a dirty sewer swamp cool?
Why?
I don't know.
Type faster.
Is that a joke, Craddock, or are you just, like, dissing Swamp Thing? Don't fuck with Swamp Thing, dude. You're going to be in Florida, which is, like, mostly swamp.
True. The glades, bro. The glades.
Can't get into Swamp Thing. Oh.
Oh, Chris can't get into Swamp Thing. Dude, I said the same shit, but the New 52, Swamp Thing was on point, dude. It was.
Even the rushed ending was still good. It was just, could have been better.
He must smell in real life. Stoneface says Alan Moore's run on Swamp Thing was awesome.
Yes.
I've heard that.
That's the one I want to read. Like, I'm working on, like, just, I've got so much shit to read, but I want to make some time for the collected editions of that.
The Bearded Uno joined. That is such a unique name.
Yeah. That's good.
I'll have to read it before commenting then.
Yeah, well, yeah, I've heard that about Alan Moore's run. It was just, like, the Swamp Thing.
Mm-hmm. We've got some questions from Relic Lord. Ramon, have you caught up on Alabaster? If so, thoughts?
Number 2 comes out next week, so I'm trying to at least read the first volume before then. Knock on wood, I will try.
How are you liking Dark Knight 3 so far? But really not.
It's the same shit as
1 and 2.
I'm actually just catching up on 2, so I haven't. I skimmed through 3 the last time Ramon read it. If you watch, I don't know when we reviewed it. Maybe it was around the beginning of December when it came out, I think.
What?
And you filled me in on most of it, yeah.
Yeah.
Burp.
It's okay. See, everybody's saying the same shit.
Mm-hmm. It's just okay.
Yeah.
I think they're kind
Somebody asked for this shit? Who asked for this?
They're just kind of milking a fucking dead cow at this point. I don't know. Have you ever considered leaving Marvel out of the show until Secret Wars finishes so you can read things in order, thereby not spoiling anything for yourselves or us, then just doing a Marvel catch-up episode?
No.
Because there'd be just too much.
It'd be too much to do one show, and we also like to let you know what shit.
Immediately, right off the bat. Ideally, Marvel should have kept to their schedule and been able to put shit, you know.
There's some shit I want for this new year from comic companies.
Uh-huh.
Beyond fucking time. One book per month.
Less events.
No events.
Or that.
Chill with the fucking variants. What else? A segment will be forthcoming on what the fuck I want from comic book companies.
I don't remember asking Ramon. I don't remember answering Ramon about this, but about Kitty being cosmic, Relic Lord says, I haven't caught up on the books enough to gauge her new abilities. I am on Secret Wars 4 and won't read any new Marvel until it finishes. If the cosmic power keeps her out of the books, I'll definitely dislike it.
Well, Relic, not to spoil anything, but I haven't seen her use her power yet. Her cosmic power in Guardians of the Galaxy. That's the book she's in now. Gamora has, I guess, her cosmic powers, mm-hmm. but she just got her ass owned, so, you know, hey, way to be cosmic. Angel still has his cosmic wingy thingies, but he's busy fucking X-23, so he's not using his cosmic powers in any way except banging her. And, so that whole Black Vortex shit was just a blip in the fucking road. It was just, no, blip on the board. You know what I mean. Oh, it was just a fucking waste of a little mini event. It was just garbage. Marvel's unreadable right now. Yeah?
There are a few shining lights, but not too many.
As a whole, it's just...
As for real-world issues in comics, I read comics to escape the real bullshit of the world, not get another big dose of it. Absolutely.
Yeah.
I don't mind reading stories involving cancer and pregnancy as a one-shot, but I read comics for escapism, not more of the things I deal with daily. So, yeah. Like, just leave the politics, leave all of the shit out. He's right. Let's have comics deal with superheroes. I don't want to read political bullshit. I don't want to read about gun control. I hear enough of bullshit about it on the news and everything. I don't want to hear about pregnancies and things like that. I don't want to hear about fucking... my hero's having cancer. Cancer sucks. It's horrible. I only wish it on people that really deserve it, like people who cut me off in traffic. They fucking deserve it. I've had family members with cancer. I know it's horrible. I want people to die. So when I say that, I mean it with the utmost of sincerity. I hate people and want them to suffer and die. I don't find anything wrong with that. As long as I know why I'm saying it. You see?
Somebody mentioned, why does Diamond have a monopoly on comics?
Diamond Distribution, you mean?
Yeah. Do you want to know about why a bike can't stand on its own? Why, Sinestro? Why?
Sinestro, he's here. There he is, buddy.
He's been here for a while.
Oh, has he? I didn't know.
He's too tired.
Damn.
About Diamond Distribution having a monopoly. I don't know why the fuck they have one. They shouldn't. Nobody's stepping up to take them out. Nobody's bitching about it. I don't know. That's a very good question.
Here we go. What are you... From David Peralta. Or say it.
Peralta.
There we go. What are your favorite Marvel hip-hop covers? Also, since you're hip-hop fans, what are your favorite hip-hop albums?
I have songs. I don't have albums.
I got a couple.
By
the way, I got my Wu-Tang variant from Squadron Supreme. Thank you.
My favorite cover is probably DMX's...
The X-23 one was a fucking badass cover. Which, by the way, the first two DMX albums, whose name escapes me. Those are two of my favorite albums of all time. Wu-Tang's Enter the 36 Chambers, pretty much anything Biggie Smalls. I'm also a big Memphis Bleak fan.
Really?
Yeah, I like Memphis. Yeah.
Look at you.
I know. I don't remember the name of the fucking album, though.
It's just...
So people just give you them burned CDs, like, here you go. Yeah. All right. Yeah, yeah, I'll listen to this. You just
put Memphis Bleak 1, yeah. And Memphis 2, and that's it. Call it that. Not that we support that.
No.
No.
But we support giving your friends stuff.
Yes.
Yeah. You had a question there?
No.
Okay. By the way, guys, we know this was supposed to be the ending of the Millennials contest, but since Roger's not here, we don't have Dimitri here or anything else, we're just going to push this contest for another two whole weeks, until we run the very first, like, feature-length Pete's Basement episode 2 weeks from now. Because Roger's not here next week either, so there's going to be more stupidity, just so everybody knows.
Yay.
For those of you who are just realizing that we're running yet another contest, the question was from Dimitri, who was the original Arsenal? It is not Roy Harper, there's your hint. Who was the original Arsenal, and when did he first appear?
Craddock says he's going to have some used engines if you want to use it as a giveaway for a contest.
Hell yeah!
Whoa. We got to find out if we can.
Wait, can I strap that shit to my truck like the fucking Batmobile?
We can. Is it legal for us to just give away used rockets? Because...
Can I give one to me for my car?
That's why we need to find out if it's legal first. Because we don't want a bunch of people blowing themselves.
You know that
up.
Motherfuckers be strapping that shit to lawnmowers like going having races down the fucking bayou.
Craddock says it's legal. Oh my fucking God.
Oh man.
The shit that legal in this country is just special. It's legal and yes. Oh my God.
Ah, that's good. Here we go.
Yeah, you know, Craddock, we'll talk about it.
I'm okay with it.
It's scary.
David Peralta?
Peralta, yeah.
Did I get that right?
Close enough.
All right. I'm white.
Yeah.
Is there anyone in the Ultimate Marvel Universe you believe should stay in the Marvel Universe besides Miles Morales? Nick Fury. Black Nick Fury. Because I really hate Black Nick Fury Jr.
Is that Nick Fury Jr.?
No, I know. He's Black Nick Fury in the in the Ultimate Universe.
Uh-huh.
He's Nick Fury Jr. in the 616. Yeah. He needs to go.
I agree. The clone, Spider Clone.
Jessica Drew.
Yes.
Yeah, love her.
Aunt May.
The younger Aunt May?
Yeah, Aunt May was kind of pretty looking in this
she
one.
She's pretty. That's because Bagley drew her.
Yeah. Anyone who use Rocket Engine, DM Pete on Instagram. LOL, Stoneface. That scares me so much. You have no idea. I'm actually worried now.
What other comic book podcast gives you rocket engines for free?
Giving it away is one
thing. I mean, y'all going to have to do some stupid shit to earn some rocket engines. I'm just telling you right
Give
now.
Give him a red shirt and put Nick Fury Jr. on Star Trek.
Yes. I don't care where you put that motherfucker. Just get rid of his ass.
I agree.
Boom. The last contract.
All right. So, it's... All right. First off, Galactus. No, Sinestro. No.
If you combine Galactus with Galactus, then yes, keep that motherfucker around.
Okay.
A superpowered Galactus that should really cunt punt fucking Kitty Pryde. Sorry, Relic Lord, but that bitch needs to go.
I need to read Ultimates because I've seen Galactus in gold and white now. Yeah, they've done.
What are you talking about, Willis?
In Marvel Comics Ultimates,
number three just came out. Yeah, I'm not up on that.
They've done shit to Galactus.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But anyways, Boom the last contract. All right. First off, Boom is doing a good fucking job. They've been dependable. They've been good. They've been consistent. They're on time, but they don't give out a lot of books. I appreciate that. This is a good little book. This old man living his life just old and going a little senile, it seems. And, he used to be a hitman, it turns out.
Okay.
And these fucking dumbasses go to him. Craddock is out. Good night, Carrot.
See you later, buddy. See you tomorrow.
Yeah. I only like Galactus and Jack Kirby style, Stoneface says. Okay. These guys come to his house to whack him.
Mm-hmm.
And he beats the shit out of him. And he's even making fun of them as he's doing it. He's like, back in the day, guys are tougher. They used to like snitch after just getting shot in the knee. It took a lot for me to get people to snitch back in the day. And he's just going at it. All right, so that's cool. So he goes back to town to find out what the hell happened. And it turns out somebody's trying to clean up something and it involves him. But of course now because of that, they're going after everybody on the list of the people he hit.
Right.
So he doesn't want to kill no more. So he's not killing innocents, but he's making sure these innocents are protected.
Right.
Mind you, he's an old crabby man.
Mm-hmm.
Like, one of the guys he killed, he put in the trunk, not to leave a dead body behind. So when he kidnapped the guy, he put him in the same trunk. Because why not, you know?
Sure.
And it's just, I don't know, I thought a lot about you when I read this book. I don't know why.
I'm going to read this one.
Yeah, you should. Yeah, I like
it. Sounds all me.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Let's go to Marvel. We didn't get a chance to actually review A-Force for you. The J. Scott Campbell cover was awesome. It's an all-female Avengers book. Take it as it is. Sure. For a girl who is into comics, this could be good for her.
Well, this is the thing. All right. We got the mini from
Secret Wars.
And that was good.
Yep.
I actually caught up to it.
Okay.
For the sake of this book.
Uh-huh.
And somebody from that book comes over in this book.
Yep.
Okay, fine. But those members are, like, so not connected at all in the current Marvel continuity. Not to mention, they're also being dealt with in very different, weird ways. Like, Secret Wars She-Hulk was badass.
Right.
Marvel main universe She-Hulk...
is back to normal.
It's back to being cartoony and dweeby and, like, horrible.
Yeah, the other one was like Xena Warrior Princess.
Yes, and this is like skin. Blah.
I know.
And then this book is like, wait.
That's the problem, is like Secret Wars was giving you these new looks at different characters and everything, and then it just totally... Right. Alright, we're done with that. Back to normal. With the exception of here's a few more characters that stayed.
Pete, all the Ultimate Universe characters need to go.
Including Galactus beating Kitty. Yeah, I agree. Anyways,
I only gave you three. I'm ready to kill all the other Ultimate Universe characters.
Ultimate Universe should have ended at Ultimatum, but that's...
Yes, it should have, many, many moons ago.
So, I don't see how there's going to be an all-female Avengers A-Force. I don't, it's just...
Well, we've got 900 other Avengers teams, what's the difference?
Yes, they're going to bring these fucking B-cast chicks into it.
I know. Well, you need more female characters to begin with.
I agree, but it's just, I don't know. Let's just see what happens. I'll stick around for maybe the first arc.
So, Spider-Man, Deadpool. I know. So anytime Spidey and Deadpool get together, when it's well written, it's gold. It was good. It wasn't perfect. I was really hoping like Jeff Loveness would be writing this.
I tried reading this book.
Okay.
Because these two motherfuckers, it's so talky.
Yes.
You get tired.
Man,
just reading like...
It wasn't bad, though. It was just... It was okay. I hope it gets better. I hope they manage to get a writer who is funny instead of just tries to be funny, you know?
Yeah.
Like, get Jeff Loveness in on this. This guy knows Spidey perfectly. This guy does
Spidey
comedy.
Wasn't that funny in this.
You know who they need to do? They need to get the writer of Deadpool Team-Up. That's what this book needs to be, is Deadpool Team-Up. Remember that book?
You love that book.
I can't say enough about this book. It was 13 issues that it should have been 1,300 issues. It was so good.
You're gonna be smiling.
How often do you get to see me smile from comic books anymore? Least of all Marvel.
Yeah, that's true.
And last but not least, Obi-Wan and Anakin. I enjoyed this one. Because I like seeing like the side stories of these two before they became
the
bitter
movies
enemies.
Don't do enough.
No.
We fucking know that.
There are years in there that we don't get to see.
That's why we love the cartoons. Oh my god, the Clone Wars was awesome. And I've grown to like Rebels.
Mm-hmm. They're both canon, by the way.
Yeah.
According to Disney.
And this is with Obi-Wan and Anakin right when he's just starting to really like using the lightsaber.
Mm-hmm.
But Anakin's thinking of leaving the Jedi Order, which is interesting. And it's just a different tale. It's something nice. Marvel is on point when it comes to the
Star Wars books.
Star Wars books.
Yep.
It's just
Disney's at the helm, man. They're doing shit right.
Their minis were perfect. Their two main ongoing books, which is Star Wars and Vader, is awesome. They're currently crossing over. It's good shit.
Yep. Oh, side story. Just on account of because. So I'm on a train going to work today. Mm-hmm. Know who I seen?
Who?
Butch from Gotham.
Ooh.
Yeah. I didn't say nothing to him. I wanted to, but he was with his girl. He had his head down. And, you know, like, sometimes you just get the impression when people don't want to be bothered. Like, if he had his head up and he was kind of looking around the train, I would have said something in a heartbeat. Because he's literally this close to me. But his back's turned. He's just talking to his girl. I said, let me not bother him. And at first, I wasn't sure.
Yeah.
You know, I was like, maybe it ain't him. But stitched onto his jacket sleeve in tonal black. It was like one of them black puffy jackets. Said Gotham Season 1. I'm like, that's definitely him. Motherfucker's a big dude.
Yeah.
Yo, he's big.
Yeah.
Yeah. Easily, like, I would say 6'4 or so.
Mm.
Yeah. But I never, ever see nobody. Ever. I mean, I lived in New York my whole life. I hear people at work, fucking hipster idiots, fucking yuppies, grandparents. They're like, oh, you know who I saw on the train? You know who I saw on the street? You know who passed me walking their dog? I'm like, motherfucker, I don't see nobody.
I once was in a diner.
I've met celebrities, but I never see nobody just in public. Till today.
Mr. Big from Sex and the City.
Oh, I know who you're talking about.
Yeah, it was
Long. Unfortunately, I know who you're talking about.
I like Sex and the City. It was funny. Not because it was good or you were realistic. I was laughing at
them.
Hey,
Kim Cattrall is still hot. No questions asked.
Really?
Kim Cattrall? Absolutely.
I think Charlotte was cuter.
She was cute. She was cute.
Yeah. Anyways.
I was peed next to Captain America Chris Evans at the Hard Rock. No lie.
I once peed next to Chris, El Sinestro. I once peed next to Chris Evans at the Hard Rock. That's pretty cool, dude. That is definitely not the place you want to ask for a photo. Definitely not. So, good call on you, sir.
I'm sure him. Did you say on your left?
That. Should have said that. That was good.
I'm sure they have some crazy stories because they have to deal with so many geeks.
Uh huh.
It must be freaking bananas.
Well, guys, that about does it for this one, the episode 1 of season 9. Holy shit. Still can't thank you guys enough for tuning in all the time and hanging out with us for a week, for, you know, an hour a week. And we love hearing from you guys on Instagram and everything. So keep up the work. I'm going to close out the show with me opening up my toys from Ramon. This one goes out to El Sinestro. By the way, El Sinestro, thank you so much for the awesome basement gifts. Seriously. Yes. That was above and beyond the call of duty of nerd friends. And I love them. They're great.
He says, I love the Periscope episodes. Right? A new plastic smell?
We love doing the Periscope episodes. Periscope episodes are some of the most fun parts we do. We are looking into the YouTube live shows, so...
That's a badass sword.
Yeah. You can buy that sword online. Like, they have the Snake Eye sword, and it's got the Arashikage symbol on it and shit.
You don't have it, why?
I don't know.
Sometimes the shit you should own, you don't own.
That is very true. I know.
You have so much shit!
I know.
But there's some certain things that scream Pete that you don't own.
They have a Snake Eyes and Storm Shadow sword. I should get them both.
Mm-hmm.
I know. Guys, we'll see you next week. And once again, be sure to tune in Saturday, 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. I will be down in Cape Canaveral, Florida. Me and Chris Craddock and Roger, we are going to film the launch of what I affectionately like to call the Pete's Basement Rocket. It is really the Craddock Basement Rocket. Just, you know, in good standing, he is the guy that built the shit and designed it and whatnot, and really all I did was slap a sticker on it. So, in all fairness, witness the launch of the Craddock Basement Rocket live on Periscope, 10 a.m. We're going to try to do like a quick interview. We talked to Chris beforehand a little bit, and, you know, just wish for the best. It's going to be good. Hopefully I can bring some warm weather back from Florida along with me. Seriously. I want to wish a happy, happy 40th wedding anniversary to my parents.
Yes.
Going this Sunday. And I want to wish a happy, happy 40th birthday to my cousin Steve. Same day.
That is a funny story.
Yep. My boy, my cousin, my buddy, my brother from another mother, Steve Cerrone. Happy birthday. And we will see you guys next week. Hit us up, questions at peachbasement.com, facebook.com/peachbasement, and follow us on Instagram and Twitter and Tumblr, and fucking, we're even on Pinterest, thanks to Roger. All sorts of things.
He hoards us out pretty well.
We are everywhere, man. And thank you to everybody who reposts our shit. That's fucking awesome. Thank you guys for tuning in all the time. Thank you for all of the letters. Make sure you subscribe to the haul, too. So you can see what Ramon and I are buying each week. And just in case maybe we miss something, Grindr, you can let us Tinder. Know. Grindr? I know what Tinder is.
I know what Tinder is. I don't know what the fuck Grindr is.
I'm almost afraid.
I'm afraid. That's a national special. Match.com. Peace Basement should have a profile on Match.com.
There was... Before we close, we did an interview with a girl at Comic-Con who invented a dating site for nerds.
Yes.
I don't remember what it was.
AshleyMadison.com.
I think I signed up for it right then and there as like a favor, too.
I am married, so technically, anyways.
Yeah, Ramon's being a good boy.
Yeah.
I'll probably be single for life and just having fun.
J-Day. Oh, my God. You guys.
I'm Italian, man. I don't. No. I can't. Do they make Italian Jews? Does that happen? I don't even know.
Similar cultures,
kind of. Salud.
Craigslist.
Peach Basement is copyright 2015, Ripped Productions, and Peach Basement LLC. All rights reserved, so go fuck yourself.
Three, two, one.